Hello, my name is Jaesop Park. I'm studying for master's degree in KAIST Bio and Brain Engineering Department. Today's lecture subject is diabetes, and it is summary of lecture of Professor Hyul Kim. The pancreas is an organ located across the back of the abdomen behind the stomach. The pancreas is made up of two types of tissue. The exocrine tissue secretes digestive enzymes. These enzymes are secreted into a network of ducts that join the main pancreatic duct, which runs the length of the pancreas. The endocrine tissue, which consists of the islet of Langerhans, secretes hormones into the bloodstream. Among cells, in islet of Langerhans, beta cell secretes hormone which name is insulin. Insulin causes cells in the liver, skeletal muscles, and fat tissues to absorb glucose from the blood. Diabetes mellitus, or simply diabetes, is a group of metabolic diseases in which a person has high blood sugar, either because the pancreas does not produce enough insulin or because cells do not respond to the insulin that is produced. This high blood sugar produces the classical symptoms of polyuria, which means frequent urination, polydipsia, which means increased thirst, and polyphagia, which means increased hunger. To diagnosis of diabetes, generally three tests are used. A fasting plasma glucose test measures blood glucose in a person who has not eaten anything for at least 8 hours. This test is used to detect diabetes and pre-diabetes. An oral glucose tolerance test measures blood glucose after person fast at least 8 hours and 2 hours after the person drinks a glucose-containing beverage. This test can be used to diagnose diabetes and pre-diabetes. A random plasma glucose test, also called a casual plasma glucose test, measures blood glucose without regard to when a person being tested last ate. This test, along with an assessment of symptoms, is used to diagnose diabetes but not pre-diabetes. There are four types of diabetes classified by the cause of diabetes. Diabetes type 1 result from beta cell destruction leading to absolute insulin deficiency, mostly due to T cell mediated autoimmune attack. Approximately 10% of diabetes in North America and Europe. Type 2 diabetes is known as caused by insulin resistance combined with relative insulin deficiency. It is most common form of diabetes. Gestational diabetes diagnosed during pregnancy because of relatively inadequate insulin secretion and responsiveness. Other specific type of diabetes are caused due to other factors, for example, disease of exocrine pancreas. Among these four classes of diabetes, in this presentation, we will focus on type 2 diabetes, which is most common form of diabetes. For a decade, people believe the cause of type 2 diabetes is insulin resistance, which mainly caused by obesity. But recently, reported experimental results suggest that type 2 diabetes is actually beta cell disease. First, recently developed molecular biology revealed the genes which correlate to type 2 diabetes are mainly expressed in beta cell, not muscle or fat cell. It means the genetic problem of type 2 diabetes are not related to glucose uptaking, but insulin synthesizing in beta cell. And second, beta cell dependent phenomenon, insulin secretion first phase, is disappear in type 2 diabetes patient. After the several study about relation between diabetes and beta cell, people found that type 2 diabetes caused by beta cell failure. As people growing up, insulin resistance is increased by several reasons such as lifestyle, genetic factor, diet, and obesity. Basically, increased insulin resistance do not directly cause diabetes because of compensation by increased insulin secretion. But after over threshold, beta cell will not withstand the overload and insulin secretion level decreased deadly. This phenomenon called beta cell failure, and it shows type 2 diabetes is disease of insulin deficiency. The reason why beta cell failure happens is decrease of beta cell mass. In normal case, beta cell mass increases with the age, which is related to insulin resistance. When people become obese, to compensate increasing insulin resistance, beta cell mass also increases. But in the case of type 2 diabetes, beta cell mass may grow slightly in the early stage but rapidly reduce after that. Interestingly, in this graph, pregnancy shows dramatic change in beta cell mass during very short time. So people thought pregnancy is good target of studying beta cell mass variation. During pregnancy, insulin resistance is developed in mother to supply enough nutrition to fetus. To compensate it, several changes occur in mother beta cell. After pregnancy, as time goes by, glucose stimulus insulin secretion increases maximum 12-fold. And during pregnancy, beta cell proliferation also increases. To figure out the molecular mechanism of this unusual phenomenon during pregnancy, researchers do mRNA deep sequencing. They compare global gene expression of islet between pregnant and non-pregnant mouse. As a result, they found several differentially expressed genes and focused on TPH1 gene, which encodes rate-limiting enzyme in the biosynthesis of serotonin. In conclusion, serotonin level increases in beta cell during pregnancy by high expression of TPH genes. At this moment, we can assume that serotonin is related to adaptation of beta cell during pregnancy. After several cell and animal experiments, researchers found the molecular mechanism of how serotonin increases insulin level by affecting beta cell metabolism. First, via serotonin 2B receptor, serotonin increases the beta cell proliferation. It causes insulin level rise by increasing mass of beta cell which secrete insulin. Second, via serotonin 3B receptor, serotonin induces depolarizing shift of membrane potential by increasing inward background current. It leads to decreased glucose threshold for insulin secretion by increasing membrane excitability. So under these circumstances, insulin easily secreted to blood. Finally, I will briefly summary this presentation with three sentences. First, type 2 diabetes is beta cell disease. Second, during pregnancy, beta cell mass variation is similar to type 2 diabetes progress. Finally, serotonin regulates pancreatic beta cell during pregnancy. I hope that this presentation may help you understanding about type 2 diabetes. Thank you for listening.